Hello student, welcome to Vastech channel. This is Vasanayak from Canara Engineering College. Today we will continue the K-map problems by using SOP expression. So you can see the problem statement is solve using SOP. Yeah, it's given SOP, and the problem statement is a function of four variables, summation m 7, 9 and summation m, and the min terms are 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. You need to represent this one by using K-map. So now the question comes whether you have to use a two variable K-map, four variable K-map or three variable K-map. Because the problem it is mentioned, in the problem it is mentioned, it is four variable. So use the four variable K-map. I have already drawn the four variable K-map here. Let me represent the min terms 7. So 7, min term 7. So this is 7. Then 9, so 9, so 10. Why we are writing here 1? Because it is SOP, min terms. That's why we are writing 1 here. SOP means grouping of ones, and min term is nothing but min terms is the fundamental products which represent 1 in the truth table. In SOP we will consider the min terms which represent 1 in the truth table. So 10, so 11. Yeah, 11 is there, correct. 12, 13, 14 and 15. Yeah, now grouping. Now you have to group. As I said in my previous session, first think whether you can group 8 ones, or can you group 4 ones, or can you group 2 ones, or can you group individual one? So in this case, you can see here we can group, we can make a group of 4 ones easily. We can't make a group of 8 ones because 8 ones are not there in continuous adjacent cells. So we can make a group of 4 ones. So let me make a first group of 4 ones here. This is the group of 4 ones, and let me call this group is G1. This is G1. Now you can make a group of 4 ones. Now just see here which are the remaining ones. This and this is the remaining one. So you cannot make a group of 3 ones. You can make a group of 2 ones, but by overlapping you can make a group of 4 ones once again. See, by overlapping you can make a group of 4 ones. Yeah, this is one more group. So by overlapping you can make a group of 4 ones. Let me write this group as G2. Then remaining one is this one. This one is remaining, this one is remaining. Yeah. But one you can write individual one, but still provision is there. 2 or 4. Which one is better? 4. So you can make a group of 4 ones. Always think big while making group. So you can make a group of 4 ones. So this is called as G3. Now remaining is this one. Individual you can write, but you have provision of making group of 2 ones. 4 ones is not possible. So I will write this is as a G4. This is G4. Now let me write the answer for G1. For G1 group circled in blue lines, horizontally all variables will get cancelled. Vertically only one row. Then so answer is very simple. Answer is for this one is answer is very simple. This one answer is AB, because it is one like horizontally top side all variables get cancelled. Then vertically only one cell or one row. Okay. Then G2 is the group circled in light green color. So this one, this group, you see here, first you see vertically two rows. So vertically two rows, and you have to see here these two row, this one rows, and which is the common here? A. Vertically you common is A, and top side once again common is D. Yeah, D. Then next group is circled in red color or orange color. Once again, vertically common is A. Top side common is C. And last group is G4. G4 span over two cells here. So vertically you have to see which is common. Vertically common is B. Vertically common is B, correct. And top side common, there is no, like only one column is there. You have to select that one only, CD. So final expression is a function of four variables A, B, C, D, four variables is equal to, actually it is a G1, G2 plus G3 plus G4, and answer is A, B plus A, C plus A, D, A, C plus A, D plus B, C, D. This is minimal SOP expression for this problem. Minimal SOP expression for this problem. So students will consider one more problem. Simplify function of four variable is equal to summation m. Summation m indicates it is a SOP and you have to group one. So let us represent first 3, 4, 5, 7, all these in min terms. So first one is 3. So first one is 3. Here I have to put 1, then 4, 5, 7, then after 7, 9, 13, 14 and 15. Yeah. Now you have to group. So normally here we will get one concept called as redundant group. Redundant. What do you mean by redundant group? Redundant means like a backup group or it is not essential group. You will come to know this one when I solve this problem. Let me solve it first. So first we will see, we will create a group. First, as I said, can you make a group of 8 ones? No. Then 4 ones? Yes, I can make a group of 4 ones. Fine. This is the group 1, 4 ones. Right? Yes. Then, now, remaining this one. You can't make a 8 one. You can make, you can write individual, no. But still you can make, you combine with this one and you can make a group of 2 ones. And we will call this one by G2. Here, this one you can combine here and we will call this is a G3. This one you can combine with this. This one you can combine with this and we can call this is a G4. And this one you can combine with this and you can call with this G5. See, when you see G2, G3, G4, that is, when you see this group G2, G3, G4, G5, we did initially G1. All the ones of G1 is shared by G2 or G3 or G4 or G5. For example, take this first group G1. This one is shared by this group. This one is of this group, like G1 group is shared by G5. This one of G1 group is shared by G4. This one of G1 group is shared by G3. That means G1 is called here, we will call G1 as redundant, not necessary. Redundant. This is called as redundant group, not necessary. So only four groups are sufficient. Which one? G2, G3, G4, G5. Let me write for G2 now. The answer for G2. So answer for G2 is that is vertically A is common. Sorry, answer for G3. Vertically A is common. And top side C bar D. This is the answer for G3. G4. G4 vertically AB. And AB horizontally, once again, horizontally, vertically AB, horizontally, you see top side, which is common C. And G2, G2 once again, vertically, no combination, you have to select A bar and B. And top side common, you see, top side common is C bar. And G5, G5 is A bar and CD. Answer is CD. A bar and CD. CD, there is no, it is a single column. So CD, but vertical it is spread over two rows. So answer is this one. So final answer I can write here. As usual, the final answer, function of four variable, I will write function of four variable. That is, function of four variable F A, B, C, D is nothing but it is a, we need G2, G3, G4 and we need G5 here. So, you know G2 is equal to, let me write G2 is equal to A bar, B, C bar and G3 is equal to A, C bar, D. G4 is equal to A, B, C and G5 is equal to A bar, C, D. Clear? So, this is the final answer, SOP expression for this problem. And here only important thing is a redundant group. Redundant group is nothing but the group which is not essential. Rest all the groups are called as essential or essential prime implicants. This redundant group is called as non-essential prime implicants. So, what you may ask, what is prime implicant? Prime implicant is the solution of that group. When you simplify that group, you will get a minimal solution that is called as prime implicants. So, in prime implicants, there are two types, essential and non-essential. Non-essential is the one which is shared by other groups. That's why it is called as non-essential.